Here, the guitar string's motion is placed alongside its recorded sound wave. Note that the attack phase of the envelope is very quick. That's where the triangular shape of the string is lost, as the upper harmonics rapidly transfer their energy to the guitar, often characterized as the twang of the instrument. The mathematical image of a guitar string is the sum of two harmonic series of waves traveling in opposite directions. Now here, the initial string shape is shown above its shape during the sustain phase. Now these are the energy waves moving from left to right, and from right to left. Again, the string by itself, and now the string and waves together. And here's another version overlaid on top of the guitar image. The sum of the heights of the wave at the endpoints of the string always totals zero. A positive wave traveling in one direction is always matched with a negative moving in the other direction, and the same at both ends of the string. And the same would be true for this idealized wave image. Moving on now to standing waves. These are shown to be the sum of two sine waves traveling in opposite directions. This imagery from FET develops standing waves from the reflection of a traveling wave. The original wave is traveling left to right. As its reflection moves back towards the left, the standing wave pattern will form along with it. The image of the guitar string as the sum of an infinite harmonic series is theoretically the same idea, but very difficult to produce with this tool. The attribution. Here are the first three standing harmonic waves. The important thing is the ratios of the completed cycles. 9 to 6 reduces to 3 to 2, which is the perfect fifth, and 6 to 3 reduces down to 2 to 1, the octave. Here is the first harmonic by itself, the second harmonic, and the third harmonic. Now here is the string as the sum of all the standing waves. It's the same shape as you'd get with the traveling wave imagery. And note that the string at this location is the sum of each of the harmonic series of waves at this point in their cycle. At least in this animated model, the string takes on the shape of the individual harmonic waves at certain times. Here's the second harmonic, and the third harmonic. And now for the relative strengths of the harmonics. Note first that the harmonic will not form at all if any of its nodes would interfere with the plucking motion itself. At the midway point, the second harmonic does not form. One third of the way along the string, and the third harmonic will not form, etc. Note that the upper harmonics increase in strength as the string is plucked closer to the bridge, and it produces a brighter, sharper sound. Here is how the harmonics are distributed to the string shape. You might keep in mind that the harmonic series is derived from studying the string and its sound, not the other way around. A touch harmonic may be the best way to show that the physical string itself vibrates in an upper harmonic mode. The string was lightly touched at the 7th fret, or one-third of the distance from one end of the string, and this node or point of no vibration forms all by itself at the 19th fret, which is one-third the length from the other end of the string.